faster.
I will stop you.
Thanks to the poor townsfolk here, the elemental has already gained more power than I need, and far more than you could ever hope to stand against. You're too late, Doctor. You have failed. Failed!
No. No! Listen to me. Our scores are to be settled away from here, from all of these innocent people.
Scores, Doctor? Yes, there are old scores between us, but this is no part of it. This isn't about you. It hasn't been for a long time.
I thought it was always about me. Surely you're not about to deflate my ego now.
Don't flatter yourself. You always did have an unhealthy sense of self-importance.
Self-importance? As capable as I might be, ruling the entire universe has never been on my to-do list. When it comes to sheer arrogance, I dare say you would have no competition in that category.
Come now, Doctor. It's always been the ego. That was one of the main differences between us. Yours could never take a beating.
My ego isn't the issue here. The issue is your mad plan to take control of the universe. This obsessive need to rule and oppress everything around you.
You call me mad, Doctor. There is irony in that statement, don't you think? I take it this is your current companion.
My name is Christine.
Christine. So full of passion, I see. Yet so innocent. Fascinating, Doctor. It is really interesting how you keep innocence so close to you. Almost as if filling a void in your spirit.
Leave her out of this. Christine has no part in our quarrels.
Oh, but she does, Doctor. You dragged her into this, her and all the rest of your companions. And you say that I'm mad? Tell me, child, would you call what I do evil?
Of course, thou foul beast! I don't think that the depths of hell would not be enough punishment for thee.
Perhaps. But what about the Doctor? Would you consider him to be evil?
No! That is a ridiculous thought! I know none of greater honor and dignity than the Doctor.
You have your pet well trained, I see. Well, my child, if you could count your years among the millennia and had witnessed the things that I have of the Doctor, then perhaps your view would not be so clear-cut.
Thou art lying!
Am I?
Doctor?
Head games are for children and idiot savants, Master. I find it difficult to separate you from the two.
Head games, Doctor? I merely offer unbiased commentary from someone who was there.
Doctor, what does he speak?
Just wordplay, Christine, nothing more.
Now who is playing the games? You are rather quick to denounce my supposed crimes, yet you are quicker in dismissing your own.
Crimes? Surely they are just jest! The Doctor is incapable of any horror such as what you have done.
Is he?
Yes! Yes! Right, Doctor?
We all have things that we regret, Christine. But there are some things even Time Lords can't undo, no matter how much they wish they could.
Doctor?
You see, child, he's not quite the hero you would have him be.
Nay! Perhaps Doctor's not perfect, but he is still the Doctor. He still has done more good than anyone that I've ever met, and I would stand by him to death.
Thank you, Christine.
I'm continuously surprised by the human need for melodrama, but I will concede one thing to you, Doctor. You do have her trained well.
Mind thy tongue, charlatan, or I shall take it with my own bare hands!
If you wish to prattle on about something, why not tell me why you came here, to Earth, for this elemental? Surely you could have hatched your schemes elsewhere.
Oh dear, is this where I unload my whole dastardly plan?
It would be convenient for me, rather than waiting for the paperback to come out.
We both know that Earth has certain special, let's say, properties about it. It appears to be a powerful nexus in the web of time, acting like a lodestone and attracting important events to itself. Now, it appears that eons ago, an extraterrestrial entity was drawn to Earth. For what reasons, I have thus far been unable to discern. A creature of exploration, much like us, perhaps. Either way, it found itself trapped here. Over the course of time, it grew weaker and weaker, until it fell dormant.
And how kind of you to awaken it.
Ah, but I cannot take credit for such fortuitous happenstance. You see, the entity feeds on the psi energies that are, for the most part, dormant in human beings. Think about it, Doctor. Think of the old Greek gods of mythology standing high upon their great mountain of Olympus. Did these gods simply exist for nothing? No, they wanted power. They wanted sacrifices from the people. They wanted worship. And as long as the Greeks and Romans worshipped them, they maintained their power. But as soon as they were forgotten, Olympus crumbled and fell. That is how this entity works. With the cultists directing their psychokinetic energy towards it, in essence, worshipping it, the entity has grown stronger and stronger, until at last it could fully awaken.
How typical. You've simply enslaved another being to do your work. Won't you ever learn? How do you plan to control it?
I have spent years working towards that goal, Doctor, and sacrificed much. I have left nothing to chance. Once I deciphered the necessary rituals to feed the entity, I knew that I could have it under my control.
Sacrificed? What could you have possibly sacrificed? Where is your TARDIS? You're usually never very far from it, yet I haven't seen hide nor column of it since we've been here.
My TARDIS was unfortunately one of the costs that was required to obtain this information. A small but necessary price to pay.
Your TARDIS?
Yes. One of the worlds that I visited, Kuon Malik III, contained some of the vital information that I needed. However, the people there were not so eager to share. I barely escaped, but my TARDIS was seriously damaged. It is operational, but only capable of one more jump through space and time.
Any particular destination in mind? Might I suggest Solaris? Very tranquil this time of year, would do wonders to help reduce your stress. I'd suggest Skaro, but we all know your track record there.
Perhaps another time. Actually, I was thinking of somewhere a little less touristy. In the constellation of Casteberus, perhaps.
What?
Yes, Doctor, I think that would be very apropos. The first casualty of my campaign will be our former home, Gallifrey.
Are you mad? Wait, of course you are. Or else you wouldn't be considering such a thing. Surely even you're not daft enough to think that you can defeat the Time Lords with the Elemental.
The Time Lords may be masters of time, but the Elemental is the master of nature. And with nature under my control, I will be able to accomplish anything. And it all begins here.
And just how did you even know to look here, in Puerto Rico, of all places?
The devil is in the details, Doctor.
Or you.
She is such a feisty one. I like that. It all has to do with culture, Doctor. Puerto Rico is unique in that various cultures have melted together into such a unified state. Native Taino Indians, Spaniards, slaves from Africa. With these cultures and folklore mixing together, the knowledge of the ancient Earth Elemental had come together but was hidden, until I was able to decode the necessary rites to unleash it.
All you needed was a spark to light the fuse.
Using the cult was easy once I demonstrated a small sample of the Elemental's power and gave them a hope for the independence of their island.
How could that do such to those poor people? All they wanted was freedom!
These people are nothing more than a tool to me. Whether they live or die is of no consequence. There are much bigger concerns. Just like old times. Right, Doctor?
Listen to me.
Okay, men, fire! Wow, it's turning to quicksand! Fall back,
men!
Fall back!
No! Call off your creature! There's no reason for this!
The Elemental is feeding off the fear of the villagers and becoming even more powerful for it. It's simply nature's way, Doctor. The strong preying upon the weak. It's been this way since the dawn of time.
Your way, perhaps. We're not finished here, yet.
On the contrary, Doctor. It's been finished for a long time.
You're allowing them to leave?
The Doctor is of no concern to us. He is too late to stop our plans.
He must die for his interference.
The Doctor is not important, Raphael. Let it be at that.
No, Master. I will kill the Doctor myself.
I have warned you about disobedience. The Doctor is not a part of the bigger picture. As long as he is not provoked, he will be no threat.
But, sir...
Pride is your greatest failing, Raphael. It will be the end of you if left unchecked.
The Doctor will be my prize, Master.
When the time comes, he will be my prize.
No, I must do this for Rosa.
Raphael! Raphael! Foolish human. But it matters little. All is going to plan.
The This is madness. What sort of creature is that, Doctor? How could they have summoned a demon like that?
It's not a demon, Orlando. I can assure you of that.
Then what else could it be? It's unnatural.
Orlando, listen. I know all of this may seem very unusual to you. As you've seen today, there are things beyond your understanding, but that doesn't make it unholy or evil in nature.
I don't understand.
There are more things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than are dreamt in your philosophy.
What does that mean?
There's no more time, Orlando. Go home. Be with your family. There's little else you can do here.
But...
No buts, amigo. You've been through enough. Get out of here, out of danger's way. I don't think Feliciano would ever forgive me if you were hurt as well.
But Raquel...
needs you at home. Go, be with your daughter.
Very well, Doctor. Good luck.
Didn't I ever tell you that I don't believe in luck?
All right, amigo. Take care.
This is horrible! The town!
I know. These people don't deserve this.
Do you have a plan?
Not yet. I'm rather making it up as I go along.
So nothing is out of the ordinary.
I try to go with my strengths.
Doctor!
Oh, Captain Mitchell, you gave me quite a start.
Not quite as bad as this creature is doing to us in the town.
Mitchell, you need to order your men to retreat.
What? No! I can't do that!
Your men have no chance against that creature!
Doctor, we have a duty to the people of this town. These people are in the protection of the United States, which means they're under my protection. I will not abandon them because of some monster.
Mitchell, I respect it. Christine! Mitchell! Christine! Christine, hold on! Christine, can you hear me? Hold on, I'm going to get you out of there!
Lieutenant! Lieutenant, can you hear me?
Mitchell, help me! Christine is trapped under here!
Captain Mitchell!
Lieutenant, help the other men up and see who needs medical attention. You may need a medic for the young lady.
Yes, sir.
You civilians need to evacuate the area. It isn't safe here.
I would agree, but unfortunately, I'm the only one who stands even the remotest chance of stopping that thing, Captain. If you don't want any more of your men killed, I strongly suggest it be you who evacuate.
Lieutenant, we're gonna need more men over here. Help me move the debris.
Coming, sir.
Mitchell, I really appreciate...
Doctor.
Raphael, just the person we need. Grab the end of this here and help us lift. Come on out, haste makes waste, as they say.
No, Doctor. No more help. Not for you or any other Gingo invaders.
What? Are you still on about that? Do you really think that the Master is on your side? Do you think he's trustworthy? Let me tell you something. I've seen it a million times before. You're just a pawn in his game. When he's finished conquering this world with the elemental, you won't even be a second thought to him. Raphael, it's time to stop this madness now.
No, it's time to stop you! This is for you, Rosa.
Enough! I suggest you surrender now, young man, or next time it won't be a warning shot.
We shall see about that. There shall be another time, Doctor.
Stop! It's impossible. How could you have moved so fast?
The elemental. He's still connected with it. Interesting.
We have to stop him.
Let him go, Mitchell. Don't you ever get tired of firing that gun?
You're welcome, Doctor.
We have her free, sir.
Christine! Christine, can you hear me? Christine?
Doctor... Oh, Doctor... My head...
Don't worry, Chris. It'll be all right. Doesn't look like anything's broken.
At least that's a bit of good news. Now, if we only had a way to stop that thing before anyone else gets hurt.
I think there might be a way.
Then I'm interested in hearing it.
We need to lure it back to the TARDIS.
The TAR what?
Well, let's not worry about that. Here's what we can do.
Excellent work, my slave. You will certainly make a fine herald for my new campaign across the universe. I wonder where I shall make my throne. Perhaps? Or Gallifrey? Oh, that would be ironic, wouldn't it? History coming full circle again.
Excuse me, you there. The one smashing the house and behaving rather poorly for a guest in someone else's country. Yes, you. Don't look so surprised.
Oh, what's he on about now?
Hey, you, elemental being. Yes, you. I'm not accustomed to being ignored like this. Pay attention when you're being spoken to. That's better. Really, now, I must admit I'm quite disappointed in you. How can you possibly have any self-respect as a hulking entity when you're taking orders from someone as obviously inferior as the Master? What manner of beast are you?
You mock me!
It speaks! Amazing! Maybe you do not lack the residual intelligence I thought you did. Well, well, I guess even I can be wrong once a millennia or two. Once. Though, to be honest, it still doesn't explain you working with a Master. Perhaps your intelligence is deceiving.
Ignore him. The Doctor doesn't matter.
Really? That's not what my mother used to tell me. Besides, if I'm so insignificant, then what are you so worried about? Surely I'm no match for your prized creature.
Do not listen to him. He is only trying to distract you from your purpose.
You are nothing.
Oh, it's good to see that we have something in common.
Fool! Do not mock me!
I'm afraid I can't do that. It is my job, as universal and temporal heckler, to provoke and annoy people. You, it seems, are currently at the top of my list, and a rather easy target, I might add. Really, the Master's other henchmen had so much thicker skin than you. Ta-ta for now!
Insignificant creature! I will crush you like...
Mitchell, excellent work.
Don't thank me. Thank my engineers and munitions experts who rigged the building to explode. That should hold that beast for quite some time.
Unfortunately, no, but it will buy a little time.
To do what?
No time for explanations, Mitchell. For once, just listen to me.
I'm not going to let that creature just run loose.
Think with your head for once, Mitchell, and not the end of a gun. Humanity can barely, at the best of times, keep from destroying itself. You suppose that you are capable of stopping this creature? No, only I can stop it. Now, stay out of the way like a good little toy soldier and let me do what I have to do.
How do I know that I can trust you to see this through?
I'm not asking you to trust me. I'm asking you to use your common sense. You've seen that creature. It is capable of obliterating your most powerful units. It will sweep your men aside like a child's toy collection. Right now, I've got its attention. Anything you do will turn its attention from me back to the town. And I can never get enough attention. Honestly, it's like an addiction. Go now, quickly!
All right, Doctor. I'll let you have your way. For now. But I'll be watching.
Don't worry, I can't be wrong. I've already been wrong once this millennia. That's my quota. I think. Pick up the pace, Doctor. Pick up the pace. I really need to exercise more. I'll make a point of it after I'm done here. Oh, wait, I still need to fix up that model train set and do the gardening I've been putting off. And, the TARDIS. Home, sweet home. Come on, come on. If I could just get you into the TARDIS.
Oh! Hola again, Doctor.
Raphael, you have an incredible knack for showing up at the wrong time. Really, I mean that.
Enough of your foolishness, Doctor. When the elemental arrives, it's going to supply me with all the power I need to destroy you and accomplish our plans at last.
Didn't we have this conversation already? The elemental is using you, just like the Master used you.
That does not matter. I know enough about the elemental now. I will take its powers into my own, harness it, become it.
Become it? Are you mad? You cannot harness the full power of that being. Yes, you can borrow some here and there, but I can assure you that—
Silencio! I have had enough of your lies. The elemental was used for our purposes, not the opposite.
Raphael, if you attempt to harness any more of the elemental's power than your body can handle, you'll—
He is to be destroyed.
No, his fate is mine to do with as I please. Conostro Ali Davidad. Retono Briani Conostro.
Raphael, what are you doing? Stop at once!
I will take all the power of the elemental into myself!
No!
I will be unstoppable and Puerto Rico will be free! Conostro Vivaldi Tryan! Conostro Vivaldi Tryan!
My power!
Yes, I Come to me. Come to me, the sound and fury of heaven. Come to me.
Raphael, stop!
No! You cannot take all my power! You cannot! No! No!
At last, I have the power to crash the heavens into the earth and split apart the dawn from the horizon. We shall have victory!
No, you won't.
What? Insolent to the end, Doctor. Do not worry. You will soon... What? Something's wrong.
Yes. Yes, I know.
I feel strange. I am growing weak. How can this be? Ow!
I'm sorry, Raphael. I tried to warn you. I tried.
What? What is happening to me?
The human body cannot contain the full power of the elemental. Some of it, yes, but not all of it. Not as much as you absorbed. Your body is burnt out.
You have done this to me.
No, Raphael. You did this to yourself. You and your single-minded goal. Such a pity. Such a waste.
Help me! My eyes! I can't see!
Your body is shutting down, Raphael. Very soon it will be over. I'm sorry.
No. Not like this. Do you resent me, Doctor? Do you hate me for what I have done?
No, Raphael. Things could have been different.
Such forgiveness. Doctor, please absolve me.
What?
You must be from God. You must have His spirit. You defeated the elemental. Defeated me. Shown such mercy and compassion. Please, Doctor, absolve me.
You have this all wrong, Raphael. I'm not...
Please, I want to see Rosa. Oh, Rosa. It's all my fault. I killed you. I killed you for a foolish dream. I gave up everything. Please, Doctor. I don't want to be separated from Rosa in death as well.
Close your eyes, Raphael.
Yes.
Recall a memory. Something peaceful, something beautiful.
I remember one day, 7 years ago. It was on the hillside, several miles from here. I took Rosa there. We spent the day laughing, talking. It was the first time I told her.
She's waiting for you there, Raphael. She is as beautiful and precious as you remember her. Rosa is there, waiting for you, and forgiving you.
Rosa.
Go to her, Raphael. Go to her.
Rosa.
I hope you have finally found peace, Raphael.
Doctor! Doctor! What happened to Raphael? And where is the elemental?
Raphael is dead, and the elemental is gone.
What? Did you take it somewhere?
No. I mean, it's dead as well.
Dead? Did you slay the beast?
No, Christine, nothing so valiant. Actually, Raphael defeated the elemental.
How could that be?
His greed, Christine. Raphael's thirst for power, even coupled with misplaced good intentions, led to his ruin.
You sound so sad, Doctor.
I'm terribly troubled, Christine. This creature was perhaps the last of its kind, and it fell victim to the senseless plans of others. Isn't that right, Master?
So it would seem.
Doctor?
Don't worry, Chris. I assume you heard everything I said.
Of course. A shame about the creature. It had so much potential.
Potential for murder and destruction, is that it? How vulgar. All of this effort, all of the wasted lives, including that of a young girl, all for your selfish ambition.
Perhaps, but there will always be death in this universe. There will always be lives wasted. Tragedy, heartbreak. Surely you're not ignorant of these things, Doctor.
It doesn't mean that you can wantonly contribute to it.
How little you understand me, Doctor. This is not the only plan I have in motion. One must always keep their options open. Isn't that what Barusa always used to say? Elsewhere, I have matters to attend to.
You mean you're going to turn down a golden opportunity? Here I am, completely vulnerable, and you're just going to walk away?
Oh, Doctor, when will you get it through your head? You're simply not that important.
You can't go on this way forever, you know. This killing, this destruction. One day you will be stopped. Forever.
Do not kid yourself, Doctor. Let us be honest with each other. You don't have what it takes to stop me. If you had the stomach for it, you would have done it years ago. Perhaps you wish to stay innocent in some small way.
Do not look at me like that.
Farewell, Doctor. Farewell, Christine. I am certain that we will meet again. Until then, I will allow you the illusion that the universe is safe in your hands. Goodbye.
Shall we follow?
No, Christine. Just let him go.
But why? They should stop him before...
There will be another time and place, but not here, and not now.
Doctor! Christine!
Ah, Captain Mitchell!
Did your plan work?
Yes, it did. You won't have to worry about the elemental ever again. How's the town?
Well, most of it was destroyed, but thankfully a lot of the townsfolk were able to escape. We've rounded up the cultists and begin the process of cleaning up. The townsfolk have been real appreciative.
That's great to hear. This looks like the beginning of a new understanding between both sides.
Yes, and it looks like things are going to work out well. Thank you for your help, Doctor.
Please don't mention it. Really, don't mention me in your report, at least not by name.
Whatever you say, Doctor.
Are we going then?
Yes, but there's one last thing we need to do.
A candle, so our daughter's soul can find its way home again.
Oh, Orlando. I don't know if I can live like this, seeing our baby girl.
Feliciana, querida, come here. We need to be strong and patient. Just give it some time.
Time heals all wounds.
Amigo!
Hola, Orlando and Feliciana. I'm sorry for barging in like this. No one answered the door.
Oh, it's okay. Don't worry about it.
Still no change in Raquel?
No.
But we're holding out hope, Doctor.
Where there's life, there's hope, Orlando. I have every confidence that Raquel will bounce back, and sooner than you think.
I appreciate your confidence, amigo.
Well, we need to go. We'll be leaving the island shortly, and we wanted to stop by and say goodbye.
Thank you, amigo. I do appreciate it, and everything you've done. There haven't been any more attacks on the farm.
And I don't expect that there will be. Everything should be back to normal by now.
Well, not quite everything.
It will, Orlando. It will.
I wanted to thank you for all your hospitality. The time I spent here with Raquel was wonderful. It was an honor.
I know that Raquel enjoyed it greatly.
I will miss you, Raquel. You are truly a wonderful friend. I hope you get better soon.
Take care.
Doctor?
Yes?
Why are we leaving so soon? Why not stay a while?
The universe is a big place, Christine. There are always new evils to fight and wondrous discoveries to be made.
But Raquel, was there not anything that you could do for her?
Christine, now you know I wouldn't just leave if I knew she wouldn't recover on her own. Orlando and Feliciana will be very happy parents quite soon. The effects of her sacrifice to the elemental are not permanent, at least now that the elemental is gone. Her body is slowly recuperating. When I was in there, I got a look at Raquel to get a feel for how long she was in that process.
You could tell just by looking at her.
Do you think I am called the doctor just because I got a silly little piece of paper? Now, come on! We don't have a minute to waste!
Feliciana, go to sleep. It's late.
In a little while, Orlando. I just don't want to leave her alone.
I know. I'll sit with her for a little while. Just get some rest.
Well, that might not be such a bad idea.
Mama?
Dios mío! Raquel!
Mom, is that you? Is that really you?
Yes, it is, Nina. Yes, it is.
Oh, Mom. It was horrible. So horrible.
It's okay now. None of that matters. You're home, safe with your family. And we love you so much, baby girl. Nothing is ever going to harm you again. We promise.
Mom.
Oh, Raquel. Thank you, Lord, for letting me keep my little angel. Thank you for keeping our family strong. Thank you for your beautiful mercy. Thank you for giving my daughter back.
Ah, there we go. Christine. Worse than a Cheshire cat. Where has she gone off to now? Christine! Oh, there you are. You really must break this habit of yours of just popping off like that. Is that the painting you were working on earlier?
Yes. Would you like to see it?
Certainly. That's very good. Remarkably good. There's something vaguely familiar about the person in your portrait, though. Do I know her?
No.
I'm sure I've seen her somewhere before. Her countenance. Particularly those eyes. They say the eyes are the windows to the soul, you know. This is your mother, isn't it?
As much as I can remember her, she was taken too soon from me.
Oh, Chris, they're never really gone. Not as long as you keep them in your heart.
I had been working on it for a while, starting and stopping. But our last stop in Puerto Rico really helped me to finish it. I saw how loving Orlando and his family were. And how well Feliciana and Raquel got along. Well, it inspired me.
Your mother would be so proud. As proud as I am of you. You certainly are growing up.
Thank you, Doctor. Now, where do you think I should hang it up? Right here.
Perfect.